Let's look at how supply and demand lead to an equilibrium in a competitive market. For both demand and supply, there are two angles from which we can examine them, and they're both useful in helping us grasp the intuition. So first, we can think of demand as telling us, for all the different values of price, what the quantity demanded is. So quantity as a function of price for any price value. But we could also look at it from the other point of view. We could see it as, at any given quantity, what is the price that consumers are willing to pay for the next unit? And that price they're willing to pay, if it is a competitive market, is going to equal the marginal benefit they expect to get from that unit. Supply works the same way, so we can see the supply curve as either giving us the quantity supplied at different prices, or as giving us at all the different quantities the price that the seller would demand in order to sell one more unit. And again, if it's a competitive market, then that price demanded by the seller's reservation price, will equal the marginal cost of producing that unit. And so marginal cost will then give us supply, and marginal benefit will give us demand. Let's then look for the equilibrium outcome. Again, it helps to look from either the perspective of quantity or price. Suppose that in this market, the currently sold quantity is here. What will be the result? Well, at this level, let's call that Q1. The price that a buyer is willing to pay for the next unit at this level is greater than the price that a seller is willing to accept for the next unit. So the buyer's reservation price exceeds the seller's reservation price. That means that we should expect to see more exchanges. So there should be the next unit that one buyer is willing to trade with the seller for. It's not necessarily clear what price that unit will be sold for, but that price will have to be somewhere between the reservation price of the buyer and that of the seller. And this will continue until we get to this point, until we get to the equilibrium price, where price equals both the reservation price of the buyer at that quantity and the reservation price of the seller. So at the equilibrium point, we'll have that P star equals PD at Q star and equals PS at Q star. And so as long as fewer than Q star units are sold, what we have is potential surplus, potential gains in the market that are not realized. Next, we could look at the market equilibrium by starting from the perspective of price. Suppose that we're at the price that's above the intersection between supply and demand, let's say here. At this level, the quantity that's demanded is going to be less than the quantity supplied. And this difference will make up excess of good on the market. So there's a surplus of product on the market. Excess supply . What will excess supply do? What will surplus of product do? Well, these will be sellers that would like to sell their output but can't find buyers who are willing to purchase it. they will be willing to sell at a lower price. Conversely, we could see the buyers as offering a lower price. As price decreases, that excess supply shrinks, and that will continue to happen until we get to the point where quantity demanded equals quantity supplied. So the equilibrium point will be Q star, where quantity demanded equals quantity supplied. Similarly, if price is below P star, let's say here, what we will have is lower supplied quantity than the quantity demanded. And so this horizontal distance, this quantity is now going to be excess demand or shortage. Shortage will drive price up because the buyers who are not able to access the good at this price will be willing to offer a little more, and that will both reduce quantity demanded and increase quantity supplied, and this upward pressure on price will continue until, once again, we get to where the quantity demanded equals quantity supplied. So we would call this shortage and this surplus. We just have to be a little careful because surplus has another meaning as well in economics that we'll get to soon.